Welcome to Work the Left Side. I'm hyped to announce tonight's guest. It is Mr. Momentum. How are you doing, buddy? You good?
I'm good, thank you. How about yourself? Thank you for having me.
Oh, mate, I'm 5x5. Not a problem at all, dude. Happy to have you on. Somebody that you kind of been popped up on my radar a while ago. Kind of wanted to get you on, talking to Jeebus about it. And Jeebus was like, just ask him. Guy's awesome. You know, it'll come on and I've got a good old chat with you. So, yeah, I reached out and here we are.
Yeah, no, thank you. I wasn't too sure because I feel like obviously you interview like big people in like the British scene. So I was like, it's a bit cheeky for me to like ask, me being still being relevant, like relevantly new. But I was like, forget it. I was like, fuck it, I'll just do it. Might as well.
That's it. I mean, everybody's got a story to tell, dude. Like, so I said, you know, from the guests that I've had on, you know, I've spoken to people. You know, I've had Jazzy Greg on, you know, from Pursuit. It's like a year into his journey. Yeah. You know, I've had RJ Singh on, Haskins, Sting, the guys that are 15, 20 years into the journey. And it's everybody's got something to tell. And it's always, sometimes it's nice to speak to people at the other end of the journey because they're still like really excitable, you know, it's all ahead of them kind of thing. So, yeah, I think everybody's got something to say. So I like chatting to you all. So that being said, obviously, you know, I said you've been on my radar for a while. I saw you at Planet Wrestle recently against the winner. You know, Jacob Quinn.
The winner. Yeah, that was my first. Yeah. So against Quinn was my first time. It wasn't meant to be. That one was like pretty last minute. I can't remember who was supposed to go against.
Somebody pulled up, yes. I can't remember. I sort of booked me now.
Posty? I want to say. Was it Posty?
Could have been Posty.
I want to say it was Posty.
Yeah. I've got the graphic somewhere.
Initially he was supposed to go, and I think he, whoever it was, I might be making Posty. It might not even be him. Paul Posty. Whoever it was. I think whoever it was just ill. So they pulled out of that show. So I got a message off Jake pretty last minute, and I was like, yeah, I'm happy to do it, because we got initially asked for the one after where it was me and Hamza versus Jake and Eve Bateman. So we initially got asked for that one. So when he asked me for that one, I was like, oh yeah, cool. I was like, I don't mind working Quinn. I was like, I love working him. Obviously been training with him obviously at PPW, so I was excited.
That's it, man. You put a good show on as well, because yeah, like you say, it's that's the first time I saw you in person. Obviously, you know, I've been watching the reels, you know, keeping up. I try, and if I can't see somebody in person, I try and catch them as much as I can. Either on YouTube or Jeebus's, you know, reels.
Jeebus's reels.
What a guy. Every time he comes up in conversation, it's always just got to kind of like, I'll always put in like a little Wayne's World.
I feel like he's just one person in like the UK scene that everyone's just like, cool. Everyone knows Jeebus. Everyone's cool with him. Shout out to Jeebus.
Yeah. Definitely. Buy yourself I'm a Jeebus Guy t-shirt if you can as well. So obviously saw you at Planet Wrestle.
Yeah.
It was good match, man. Obviously, like you sort of said, you're familiar with a lot of those guys because of the Pursuit connection. That's another thing I want to address at some point. I shall just bring it up now. The last few videos I've seen from Pursuit of music. Mate, he's bending you like a pretzel. The last two or three music videos, I'm sat there like, poor Mo. What are you doing?
I love Vusik. I feel like he's such a good like in-ring worker. I feel like he's really good. And it was some point, so I started going to Pursuit from like last year, I want to say. So I think he was roughly about there a couple of times. So that's when I slowly got to start to know him. And then recently he's like slowly just like started coming back. And then he's been like, oh, can I just like try some like fun stuff? And I'm like, yeah, that'll be fine. I don't know what goes on. He thinks so much differently. Like he's like, oh, I could do this to this. And I'm just like, I don't know what's going on here. I'm just following you. My legs like fucking behind me. My arms are like, going a different direction. I'm like, I don't know what's going on. But I'm like, cool, that's fine. I was like, I'm just going to work with you. I was like, I'm not going to question it. I was like, I'm just going to go with you right now.
Just let the man do what the man does. I think I jokingly commented on one of them, like saying, oh, man, Mo's going to be like 7 foot tall after all this kind of thing. He's just stretching you out. He's just like,
and I'm just acting like, I don't really know what to do. But I was like, that's fine. I was like, I'm just going to do whatever you do. I was like, it's fine. I'll just work with you.
Right, let's get the generic box ticked. I kind of hate doing the generic stuff, but people need to know. People are always interested. Yeah. If they don't know much about you, it's a good way to learn. So, I mean, what made you take them steps, you know, through a training room door in the first place, wherever it was, you know, where did you first start training?
So initially it was, so I never, I'm going to be honest, being a wrestler wasn't really like a key thing on like my bucket list. I feel like when I was younger, when I was about 15, 16, I tried to have a look into it, but I couldn't find anything. I might just have been like looking in like the wrong place, or I didn't really know where to look and what to do. So I don't know. I've always been a fan of wrestling. I feel like some people, they always be like, oh, this is the match that I got into wrestling and this. I couldn't really remember. I've had my favorites, for example, like Rey Mysterio, Rob Van Dam, Eddie Guerrero, like they're like the main ones that I loved watching, but I couldn't remember like a specific match where I was like, oh yeah, this is why I'm into wrestling. But yeah, initially I was just like watching it just because I love wrestling. And then it was Hamza. So me and Hamza have known each other from like sixth form, since like school. We knew each other since then, but he wasn't that much of a wrestling fan. I think he's slowly like fallen out. And in my school, like no one like liked wrestling. I think I was literally like the only person. So I was like, oh great, I like this, like, and no one else does. So I'm like, oh great, I've got no one to talk to about this. And then it was during COVID. Hamza slowly started to get back into wrestling, and he started, and that's when we started proper like going talking back and forth properly, and we're just on about wrestling like 24/7. And after COVID, he started at UKW. So he initially started there, and then we met up after a while, like when we could actually meet up properly after COVID. And he was like, oh, I've started wrestling. He was like, why don't you try coming down? And I'm like, oh, I don't really know about this. I was like, I'm not too sure. And I'm like, it seems a bit much. And he was like, no, trust me, you'll love it. I got there, and it was the first session. Obviously, with everyone being there, I was a bit like, oh, I don't really know what to do here. I'm like, everyone knows what they're doing, and I'm just brand new, and I'm like, I don't know what to do. But honestly, as soon as I got in the ring, obviously it's so much harder than it looks. Even like the simple things, just hitting the ropes, I was like, I don't know how to do this. I can't. My feet just didn't work. I had like two left feet. I was like tripping over myself. I was like, it just felt unnatural. Then obviously, I started to get more into it after the first session. When I first took my bump, I was like, oh, I quite like this. And I slowly started to go a bit more and a bit more. And then, yeah, it was just from there, slowly made my debut in UKW, I want to say roughly about like 4 months into training, which I was very surprised about because I was still like pretty new. But yeah, I just, once I made my debut, I just took it and ran with it. I was like, if I'm here, I might as well just do it as much as I can, just get used to it, just get more reps in. But yeah, it was initially Hamza, that's it, that took me eventually to going to start wrestling.
He introduced you, he kind of like led the way. He was like, come
yeah,
on.
He was like, come, you can start wrestling, you can start to do all this fun stuff. Because I've always been into like contact sports. It's like, for example, like I'm not the biggest like football fan. I've been more into like, for example, like boxing and like UFC. Like I've always done like stuff like that. Like since I was a kid, I just started with like karate. After that, like got my black belt. That's like one thing that I wear whenever I like wrestle, just because it's like a little nod to that, just like what I've done. From there, I did like Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, and then from there, obviously, I started wrestling. So in terms of like physicality, I've always loved like the physical side of wrestling. That's why in terms of like taking hits, I love it. Like I just, it's weird to say like out loud in like public, people can be like, you're like getting hit, I'm like, are you like mentally okay? It's just like, it's different, it's like a different type of like, yeah, it's a different type of buzz that you get, like you can't describe it.
It's an adrenaline, like,
yeah,
you know,
it's adrenaline rush.
It's not like you're not stepping in and getting hit straight away. The adrenaline builds up.
Yeah.
It's like, right, it's, there we
just,
go.
As soon as you come out the curtain, you can hear people like screaming or booing, whether you're good, bad. It just gets you right in the mood, and it's the best feeling ever.
Exactly. If you stepped out the curtain and somebody punched you in the face, it would feel a lot worse than if somebody punched you 5 minutes later.
Yeah. Like in the ring, I'm like, yeah, hit me a lot in the face. Cool. Drop me on my head. Please don't, but like in a safe way. But like, yeah, I'll take this, I'll do this, I'll perfectly do that. Let's have fun. I was like, honestly, it's just having fun in the ring. I honestly just love everything that I do. Everything, like, anyone that I work with, literally, I'm always like, cool, we can do fun stuff with like this, that, the other. It's just like putting what you do and what they do and just merging it together. I feel like that's like the best part of wrestling.
It is, it's like a, yeah, an amalgamation of like both people, you know, like the best of everything, you know, hiding the, you know, the weaknesses but amplifying the strengths, you know, using each other's abilities to just level up, kind of thing.
Yeah, it's just, it's like a puzzle piece, really. Like, you're literally just fitting each other's moves into each other, different things that you can go out, swapping back and forth, and it's just an art. It's just really good art form.
I'm interested in the like the martial arts and the Brazilian jiu-jitsu kind of thing as well, because I've spoken to, you know, a few people that have done like martial arts before getting into wrestling. And I know you sort of said when you was running the ropes, it's like having two left feet, but when you're moving around the ring, like transitioning, you know, they kind of sort of said it was a little bit easier because of the footwork.
Yeah, with the martial arts. Yeah. So with that, I feel like in terms of just like running the ropes, I feel like it's different to like working with people going around in terms of like doing move for move. So I feel like that with the running ropes, it was a bit like, it's fine. I obviously eventually with like time I got used to it. But in terms of like bumps, I feel like I was a bit lucky. So with the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, we learned how to kind of like bump, but it was like a very like simplified one. So we literally like sit down and just roll back and do it. So I kind of knew like the concept of breaking your fall, but in wrestling is obviously just from standing up. So I was like, oh, this should be all right. So it wasn't as bad, yeah. So I was like, I kind of get it, maybe, hopefully. So it wasn't as bad in terms of like learning bumps, because it was something that I already kind of knew how to do before. It was just from like a different type, if that kind of makes sense.
Yeah, no, that makes perfect sense, dude. So, but again, you know, with that kind of background, you know, obviously, you know, I'm messing about, like saying, you know, like Vusik's like bending and pretzeling.
Yeah.
You've got the ability, dude. I'm expecting now. I want to see two or three videos of you being like, no, right.
I'm doing this to you. No, he'd break me in half. If I started, he'd be like, no, he's just going to break me in half. I was like, I wouldn't even try it. I'd be like, that's fine. I was like, you just take over. I was like, you just do whatever you want. I was like, don't trust myself. I was like, you can just break me off. It's fine.
But dude, no, I mean, again, you know, so, you know, based on what I've seen of you in the ring and stuff like that, you know, it's kind of, now you've said it, I'm like, okay, I can kind of see a little bit here and there, but it's not something that you kind of, it's not obvious. I wouldn't think of your character as like a, you know, like stiff kicks or stiff blows excessively, yeah. You know, like your Vusiks or your Wades or Jet Marshall, yeah. Guys like that kind of thing. Obviously, you've kind of gone down a different, but it's kind of cool to know that you've got that. You know, if at some point, if Mo snaps,
yeah,
man, he's going to kick your head off.
Yes, it's good to have. So like, it's different types of it. So if I did want to, for example, like, I'd love a match with like Fusik or Joe Wade. I just love the stiff test. For example, when I saw them at the first Pursuit show, I was there watching it. Their match was brilliant. I suppose it was one of my favorite. It was so good. Exactly, my mind was blown. Everything that I was doing, I had no words. So I'd love to get in the ring and do that type of style. But I was like, I can also do different types of style, where it's like a bit quicker and like flashy and like high flying as well. So it's like different styles that you can switch out and incorporate into like my wrestling style, which is fun, because always like if people expect one thing, obviously I can kind of switch up. If they're like, oh, he's already done this, I can like, oh, but I can also do this instead. So it's like different parts that people will always get to see.
That makes perfect sense, but it's also good for you, because you know, people I've spoken to, they've kind of made reference to, you know, like if they're booked on a show, you know, yeah, they'll look at the card, look at the sheet, see who's working. And if they see somebody with a similar style of what you wanted to do, you could be like, okay, no, I'll let them run with that. I'll do this instead. There's nobody on the sheet, no, that's doing what else I can do. So I'll mix it up tonight. I'll be a little bit different. And that's, you'll stand out then.
Yeah, because obviously with the card, it depends, obviously, like where you are, the card order, and the types of wrestlers you have. So obviously, if there's no one doing that type of style of match, if I'm doing it, then it'll hopefully make me just look better and just make me stand out more, like you said, yeah.
That's it. It's just, again, it's just having different strings to your bow kind of thing. You know, you don't want to be stuck doing one thing. You know, as a fan, we'll be like, okay, we know what to expect. It's awesome. But every now and again, you mix it up, but it keeps it fresh for you as well. If you're going out doing the same old thing,
Because sometimes I can imagine
getting a bit wary.
Yeah, because I feel like sometimes, obviously, if you're going through the same thing and just doing it, for example, like, if you are, like, booked every weekend, or, like, every other weekend, let's say, if you're doing the same thing over and over again, it does get a bit, like, tiring. I'm just like, oh, I would like to do something different now, maybe. So that's why it's fun, like, at least I can switch up my styles. I'm like, cool, I've got this side that I can do. Also, I can do, like, the flashy style, the high-flying style, the super light fucking, if I want to kick someone's head off style.
Yeah, obviously, when I saw you at Planet Man, that was just fun. High energy, yeah. High flying, and yeah, you know, dude, from my side of things, you were running them ropes, and it was just like, wah, chef's kiss, you know, you've mastered, you know, it looks smooth, dude. So, no more two left feet.
Anyway. Yeah, no more two left feet. It's a bit, yeah, left and right now. It's changed one of them.
Again, you know, I've heard it sort of said, you know, I don't see different promotions or different rings have got different kinds of ropes, but
yeah,
I remember speaking to somebody once and they were just genuinely shocked, like the first time they ran the ropes and it just being like, ouch, you know, I didn't expect the ropes to actually hurt when I hit them, kind of thing. You obviously get used to it, but the first few times you do it, you're like, ooh, okay.
Because some of the stuff like that you do in the ring, it's like, you don't expect the little things to be as scary as the big things. Because obviously when you do like bumps, you're looking at me like, oh, that hurts. And like, yeah, it does. But like, you eventually, obviously, you're like, you'll get used to it if you are doing it continuously. But it's like other things like getting out of the ring. Like going out of the ring is scary. You're literally throwing yourself over the top and like just hoping that you just land safely at least. But otherwise, you're just landing on top of your head. That's like that. Even like people are like, oh, going off the top rope. Like it's high up there. Like, I know, I've started to do some stuff off the top rope now and I'm more comfortable with it. But at first I was up there and I'm like, I don't really know if I want to jump off now, especially onto the ring with normal back bumps hurt. I was like, you want me to jump off from up there and then do it? I was like, I think I'm okay. But no, it was like just getting used to it. It's just like a lot of things.
And at that point you decided just to be like a ground technician and just never leave the mat.
I'll just stay on the floor. I was like, I won't jump in. No, I was like, I'll just stay on the floor. It's fine.
Just shadow Liam Slater and just be like, right,
yeah,
I'm going to
I was like, Liam, I was like, just teach me everything you know, please. I was like, I'll just copy all of you. It's fine, hopefully.
Chain wrestling, yeah. Like,
yeah.
Well, that's it as well. I mean, obviously, yeah, we talked about Pursuit briefly beforehand. I was all about the villains, but obviously, you know, anybody who knows this channel, I've probably been about 20 odd people now that I've spoken to, you know, from Pursuit. I love that place. I just think it's, you know, everything I see about it is amazing. The atmosphere, it's just the people that go there as well all seem to be very, very cool, very awesome human beings. You all just kind of seem to be this like big whole crazy misfit wrestling family, but that help each other. And it all seems very genuine, which is why I think I radiate towards it.
Yeah, I feel like for like PPWs, I might be biased, but I'd say it's like the best wrestling school in like UK. I'd probably say it's like one of the best is the best wrestling school in the UK. I felt with like everything that they do, with like the promotion that they do, the wrestlers that they have, and like everyone like helping each other, I feel it's like a really good environment for people that either whichever they are like points in their career. If they're just starting off, you'll get like people that are helping regarding that, or if you are like couple of years in your career, you'll get like people who are like bigger wrestlers, for example, like Jet Marshall's usually there, Kid Lycos too's there, obviously you get Liam Slater, they can help you with like different feedback as like in different types. But yeah, obviously with Liam as well being the main coach, I feel like he's such an incredible wrestler. I feel like he's one of the best in UK. I feel he's very like underrated. I feel like he should be absolutely everywhere. I'm surprised, not just the way that he like thinks of like wrestling is just different in a good way. Obviously, like he's just pieces things together and can pick out small things which, for example, like someone else might not have noticed. And I feel like that's why they're going to like PPW so much, just because everything that they do, as like as well as Liam's coaching, is just, I feel like it's the best in the country, really.
It's up there, you know. I've had the pleasure to speak to numerous people. I can't say, you know, I don't want to. I have to sit on the fence, kind of thing. Yeah, you know, everybody knows my love for Pursuit. You know, that's unbiased. That is just. But you know, I've spoken to like House of Pain, Future Shock. Yeah, they're all very, 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 very cool. But I do think I don't remember seeing those schools going to Spain or going to Mexico.
Yeah,
you know, basically doing little mini world tours. you know, taking talent with them and putting on shows elsewhere. So I think that makes it stand out. I can say that as a fact, I think. And I'm not being biased. I'm not besmirching anyone. It's just...
Because they've been going recently. I think... Oh, where did they go last time?
Mexico won it. Oh, Spain. No, was it Spain or France?
It was Spain because Mexico, they went... I think, because I think they went Mexico beforehand. Yeah. I think they went Spain recently.
Look, I was talking to Lawson about going to Rome.
Okay, that's fine. Cool.
First school, that's crazy.
Yeah, it's just, it's Nathan as well. I feel like he's very good at, like, pushing reels out, his favourite. Nathan and his infamous reels, he'll always come to someone who'll, like, if we're, like, practising, like, a move, and he thinks it's, like, obviously, if it looks good, he'll just sneak up behind them and be like, oh, can you do a quick reel for me, please? Like, is it okay? And we're like, for God's sake, Nathan. But yeah, no, I love Nathan as well. I was like,
But, you know, when you're doing them, dude, you're going to be, I mean, some of them numbers, you know, on their Insta account, the clock does stop. Some of the reels have got like millions of views.
Yeah, I was like, it's crazy to think about that. Like, I find it crazy because I remember like watching the reels before. Like, before I actually started to come to PPW, and I was like, this is such, like, it's so cool. And now I'm like, oh my God, I'm in some of the reels now. I'm like, it's just weird. Like, it's just, like, it's just weird.
That's it, dude. You know, yeah, you've been seen by millions of people now. How crazy is that? Just, again, I go like that.
Yeah.
But it's exposure for you. And that's, you know, that's the whole social media side of things that I've talked to about so many times, you know, using it to the advantage, you know, whether it's talent or school or promotion. You know, that just goes to show you put the reels out there and you make them look good. Potentially, you've got millions of eyes to view what you're doing.
Because I feel like with that one thing, I feel like with, like, social media, I'm not the best. So sometimes when there is a reel, I'm like, oh, cool, I can just, like, post this on my page. I was like, I can just share it all out. Almost like it gives, like, people look at, like, how I work, which is good. It was like, it gives them a little, like, taste of what, if they were to, like, wanting to book me, they can just see how I am, like, in the reels as well.
It's free advertising, dude.
Yeah, can't go wrong with it.
Talking of, recently had Mr. Gung Ho Mutley on. So that's kind of, I'm going to jump over to Breakout.
Yeah.
Have you been there recently? Again, it's a promotion. I think it's kind of building momentum. From what I've seen, there's a lot of very cool stuff going on there. I know there's a few guys from Pursuit as well, you know, that go. I think Lawson was on the last show I just mentioned. You enjoy working Breakout?
Yeah. So the the show that we were just on, that was our first time being on it. It was really good. So we got booked as me and Hamza together as NRG, and we're up against the Denizens. So it was really good to, like, get out, and it's like a different venue altogether. So it was good for us to get the experience of, like, going to somewhere completely different, which is like a bit of a drive wave to, like, a new, completely different crowd, people that might not know us, and getting that type of experience as well. Because I feel like it's different to going to a place that you already are at and then going to a crowd that already knows you. So it's good to get that, where you're going to a new place and trying to build that connection with, like, the rest is there, the crowd there, the promoter there, and, like, hoping that, like, they bring you back. They seemed really happy with, like, the match that we put on. It was a really good match as well. I was, like, really enjoyed it, and so did Hamza. So, yeah, hoping to be back there as well, hopefully. Fingers crossed.
Okay, I think, you know, you fit perfectly there, you know, from the shows that I've seen, the talent that they use. You know, I could see NRG, you know, absolutely, you know, tearing it up kind of thing. I was going to make reference to that at some point, but you meant, you know, the Last Planet show, when obviously, you know, you came out as a tag team, and it was then, that was like the hometown boys came back kind of thing. The reaction you got at the Last Planet show.
And I'm going to be honest, I didn't expect it. I was like, they're not going to know who we are. But no, I was like, I didn't expect it, because obviously I think that's the... Because obviously it was in Bradford, and where me and Hamza are both from Bradford. I think that's the first time that we've actually wrestled there. Yeah, I don't think we've ever wrestled in, like, Bradford. So it was just, like, a nice place to wrestle. I was like, obviously it's a home city. I was like, and everyone, like, seemed to love the match as well. I was like, and everyone was fucking popping. So I was like, you can't go wrong. I was like, it's the main thing. If everyone was, like, happy, enjoying, having fun, I was like, it's the main thing.
That reaction though, dude, like, say literally just the roof could have just gone right straight up. I think there was facts as well, you know, you was whooping on Jake, always kind of helps at a planet show, you know.
Jake. I was like, love Jake. I was like, with his real American accent.
Oh,
accent.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, that dodgy English one he does occasionally is a bit like, just sounds really fake, but yeah, you know, when he actually speaks with his proper accent, you can just understand why you want to punch him in the face, to be fair.
Yeah, but no, I really liked enjoying having a match against both him and Eve Bateman, especially they're both like, honestly, they're both very good in the ring. Especially like me and Hamza have been wanting to have like a match with like fucking Crashbot. I feel like they're one of the teams that me and Hamza would love to have a match against. So I feel like with having Jake, I was like, ooh, I was like, this is really fun. I was like, it would be cool if we had like Bandy and Jake. I was like, in a both team. I was like, it would be really good. I was like, that's one match that we'd love to have against them.
I could see that at like a True Brit or something.
Yeah.
That's one to keep your eyes on. I won't want to put a timescale on it, but I'd sort of say what we're in June, if not by the end of the year, first half of next year. I wouldn't be at all surprised if you saw NRG versus Crashbot.
Hopefully, that's one. Yeah, they're definitely one of the teams that would love to actually, like get in the ring with. I feel like it'd be such a fun match. I thought we watched them for a while, and we're like, we would love to get in the ring with them.
Yeah, man, I would pay to see any promoter. Watching, you know, I would pay to see that match. So if you announce that on a show graphic, take my money all day, every day kind of thing, I'd be well hyped for that.
Yeah.
So obviously you can't happen at Planet because, you know, Trash Mode don't exist. Jake's the baddie.
Yeah, no, Jake's with Eve Bateman in a love-hate relationship.
Love, yeah, I don't even know. I won't even want to know what to put it as, but yeah, it's definitely hate on one side.
Yeah, it's a bit hate on one side, a bit love on the other, though. Just whatever they want to call themselves.
So, I mean, are you, obviously they're starting to hype up the next Planet show. I saw you guys on the poster, right?
Yes, yeah, so I'm on the poster and I'm going against Nathan, which will be fun. So I'm looking really forward to that match because I've never actually worked with Nathan like, at all in terms of like anything, like even in like training, if we've done stuff, we've never actually like locked up or like done anything in the ring together. So I'm really excited to see like what we can put together and what we can do. And I feel like Nathan's really good at like chatting shit. So this will be fun as well.
What you want to do is get him down, transition, put him in a submission holder, just get Jeebus to sort of get a close up personal reel.
You know,
and then just say to
I
Nathan, how's it feel? How's it feel?
You know what I might do? I'll do that. I'll get Jeebus's form beforehand. I was like, I might just borrow it. He'll be fine with it. He's a nice guy. I'll just shove it in Nathan's face and be like, this is what you deserve. I'll just make sure his face just full on just in the screen. I was like, this is what you deserve, Nathan.
Payback.
Yeah.
The tables have turned. Dude, there you go. Massive pop. Everybody's happy.
Can't Nathan gets Jeebus, place. Jeebus gets his reel as well. There you go, helping Jeebus with his reel.
It's up close and personal.
Yeah.
Nathan gives Jeebus shit all the time as well, kind of thing. So, you know, he'll be up for it, just get payback.
I felt the amount of times, like, every time I see a reel, and it's like, someone, and Nathan Black. And it's like, Nathan, like, chatting shit to Jeebus walking past. He's like, oh, how you doing? And I'm like, oh, God. Oh, not this again.
That'd be awesome. Oh, dude. If it happens, amazing. If it doesn't, you know, it don't, but I'm just thinking, I've got that in my head now. I'm like, oh, wow.
Don't worry.
You know, Jeebus will be watching this.
I'll try to make it happen, don't worry. I'll try to make it happen. See what I can do for you.
I know Jeebus is going to be watching this, obviously, because, you know, it's you kind of thing as well, and he's the one who kind of put the seeds in place. So he's always asking, when are you talking tomorrow? I was like, oh, you know, it was meant to be a couple of weeks ago. Got rescheduled. It's happening tonight.
Yeah.
Like, so, yeah, we were excited. So he'll probably come to you. Just like take my phone,
I'm like, cool. I was like, I'll hold it. I was like, I can do like Natalie Sykes's gimmick, I'll take some selfies with it for you, I'll take some like cool photos.
Point of view, highlight reel,
there you go.
Like, I don't know, Doom or Call of Duty style, but would you want a point of view wrestling match? Highlight
there you
reel,
go. Like, it would sell. There's nothing, I don't think anyone's done that. I think that's a good selling point, to be fair. I was like, not many people have done that.
That's a character right there. Somebody wrestles with like a little camera, a headset on.
Like headset and camera, so you can just see like, yeah. Do you know what? Yeah. That might have to be a new gimmick. Forget NRG. Oh, forget NRG. That's it. Sorry, Hamza.
No, don't do that. I feel too bad. No. NRG rules. Please don't disband the band. But yeah, obviously, we talked breakout. I mean, fingers crossed as well, you know, Pursuit have just announced a second Pursuit show. You know, I know people are going to be clamoring to try and get on that kind of thing. I'm saying True Grit, but, you know, put a word in, maybe, you know, maybe get NRG versus Crash Boat at Second Pursuit.
Could do, yeah, because I've been, I was like, obviously, like, I go to like True Grit shows to watch. I feel like they are both, obviously, True Grit is very good. I think I was on it for the last show that they did in York. I made two appearances. So one of them, I was like Ian Skinner's corner boy. And then the other one, I was Lily Winters' step. So during her entrance, because she has like a big coat, there was no steps to get into the ring. So she asked, so Sandy came up to me before the show and she was like, hi. And I'm like, hi, Sandy, are you all right? And she's like, yeah. She was like, are you on the show? And I'm like, no, I'm just here to watch. She was like, would you like to be part of it? And I'm like, can do. Yeah, obviously. What would you like me to do? She was like, you're going to have to be a step. I'm like, excuse me? She was like, yeah. She was like, so obviously she explained like Lily Winter has a big coat. And I'm like, okay. And she was like, yeah, just come. And I'm like, I just went to go talk a little bit. And she was like, hi, are you okay? She's very nice. It was the first time that I met her. And she was like, hi, how you doing? Nice to meet you. She was like, yeah, I'm just going to just drag you and throw you on the floor and just stand on top of you, just get in the ring. And I'm like, okay then. And I was like, oh, okay. I was like, fair enough, I guess. It's probably the most weirdest thing that's ever happened to me at like a wrestling show where I've not been on and then managed to get on is to become a step. Yeah. Dude, probably the weirdest thing that's happened.
Every step counts, dude. That's all I can say.
There you go.
It's a step in the right direction.
There you go. I'm trying to think of more step puns, but I can't think of anything.
One step too far, dude.
Oh.
But that's it as well, though. You know, despite, you know, obviously, you know, we sponsor True Grit. I always hype them up whenever I get a chance, kind of thing. But it's awesome to kind of just see whether you're being a step, whether you're working security, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
You know, as long as you've just been there, though, getting your face seen. Because, you know, somebody sort of said, you know, 87% of wrestling is just networking, you know, getting your face out there, talking to people, going to shows, helping out. And yeah, if you're doing that at True Grit, you know, that's at least they know your face.
Yeah, that's why I feel it's good, because I feel like PPW, again, back to PPW, I feel like it's a very good place for like networking with the amount of people that are there, especially with like, for example, like match feedback and everything. Like one thing that I'll do is that every time I've had a match, Liam might find it annoying. I was like, I always like bubble him, like, can I get feedback on this? Can I help with this? Can you sit me away? Can you talk me through this? Can you do this? Can you do that? I feel like I do get a bit annoying that aspect. But yeah, there's like loads of things, and the different people there help as well. For example, like Kid Like Us Too, obviously he's there frequently as well. So I have ask him if he can come like watch some of like my and Ham's like tag matches and go through it and help with like things that could change, things we can make better, and just like for some advice, since he's obviously like part of like costume, who's like sick tag team as well. So it's good to get like different perspective from like different wrestlers as well, in like different types of wrestling, if you're like a singles wrestler or like a tag like specialist as well.
You think you've got just such a wealth of experience or knowledge or styles.
Yeah.
You can just pick just like brains and just be like, you know, like I said, Lycos Gym, dude, you know, top five tag team in the country kind of thing.
Oh, 100%, 100%. I love watching them, because we went to the last North show and they were against Medusa Complex. It was such a good tag match. I was like, oh my God. I was watching it and I was like, we're supposed to be helping out. And I'm like, I'm just watching this. I should really be helping out and like doing other things. But I was like, I just want to watch this wrestling.
Just transfixed, man. Yeah,
and just
take it as a compliment, but damn, you know, yeah, I should be here to help, but it's their fault, man, for putting on such good matches.
Like,
you know,
they're just too good. I was like, they're too good wrestlers. I can't not watch so much. It would be an insult to them.
Exactly. You don't want to be smircher. You don't want to be that guy. So, yeah, you know, just watch the match. But that's the thing as well, though. You've got those brains to pick, you know. It's just, obviously, you know, Joe Reid, Alan Kay, Misery Business, you know, you kind of got... go for that. So, you know, if you're looking more at the sort of speed and style, speed and strength dynamic, Axel and Gentleman Jim, you know, from character work, it's all there.
Yeah, it's just, there's loads of different people, and it's just PPW is one of like the school where you can get a bit of everything from like anyone who's there. There's always like someone there who can help you with a certain style, or like a specific match type if you want to do it, which is like the really good thing about it.
Yeah, it's just like, say, and everybody seems so genuine and happy to help. You know, nobody's kind of holding back because they don't want somebody else to succeed. You know, everybody's giving 100% to everybody else. You know, I've spoken to people just like as Leon Slater was, you know, going to the moon kind of thing. And again, just everybody's so genuinely so happy for him kind of thing. There's no resentment. No, it should have been me. Everybody's
everyone's like really happy for Leon. I don't think I've heard anyone like jealousy or anything. I feel like everyone is like, because I feel like he's around the area and everyone like knows of him as well. So I feel like everyone was just happy that he's made it to like freaking like TNA, which is like still like mind blowing. Like it's just like, it's no words to describe it. It's just mind blowing.
But it's awesome. But sure, I mean, you guys though can kind of then look at that and be like, you know, it's an achievable goal. It kind of does it help you sort of buckle down and be like, right, okay, you know, if we do give it 110%. You know, this shit is possible. We can do this. Does it make you just sort of strive for it more?
Yeah, because obviously if we've seen Leon do it as well, because when we first started PPW, the first session that we went to, well, obviously me and Hamza have been wanting to go for like a while, but we've just been like continuously like putting it off. But obviously just because it's like a new place and we're like, oh, we don't know how it'd be, we don't know how it'll feel. Obviously, we knew it wasn't going to be like bad. But it was just like an anxiety thing for both of us. And then when we eventually went there, there was like Jet Marshall. That was the first time we probably talked to him. Liam was the first time we probably met him and talked to him. There was obviously like us too. There was Leon there as well. We're like, oh, there's so many like big wrestlers here. We're like, do we even fit in here? Would it be like, will people be like, oh, what are these two doing here? But it was, honestly, it was the complete opposite. Everyone was like really welcoming. Everyone was like, oh no, you can, like, they're really like helping us out, which is the best thing. Obviously, no one made us feel like isolated as well. So it was like, it was really like welcoming BBW when we first went as well.
That's awesome. That's, again, you know, I'd say it's just like that kind of vibe. Well, it's like Blackheart Wrestling as well. You know, it's another show that I'm kind of close to in regards to. I'm trying to hype as much as possible. You know, I push the shit every, you know, I push the shit every week kind of thing. Not, you know, I've pushed the episodes on YouTube, you know, talent. I know you've been, you know, both NLG have, you know, had a few tag matches at Black Hawk.
Yeah. The last one, so, what was the last one? What did we put it on? It was a tag match when it was the Wrestle Island Temple Takeover. So where
it's only a few weeks ago, that was, wasn't it, really? Yeah, weeks ago?
Yeah, it wasn't that long ago. So we had, it was the Gala and EJ. So obviously, that was the first time we initially, like, met. When it got announced, we were, like, we followed each other and we were, like, messing each other back, which was, like, fun to do and, like, starting, like, beef. But, yeah, when we met, we were, like, they were really good in the ring. We were, like, really happy to work with them, and we're like completely new people that we've never met, new tag team. So it was fun to like I said, put our both of our like tag stuff together. It was really good working with them. They were really good in the ring.
I mean, and I kind of popped for that because again, you know, besides Pursuit, I've spoken to a lot of guys from the Temple. Obviously, you know, Sean Only training over there. Sammy Blue, obviously, Billy Keith, J. Ro Lewis, Gala. So I was kind of really happy to see Temple guys come over as well, just give them a bit more exposure. And it's also matches I've never seen before, like you just sort of said, you know, you guys in a tag match with those guys. It's like, oh, okay, as a fan, I was like, that got my interest straight away.
Yeah, because it was literally, it's like complete opposite sides. So that's why when we got announced, we were like, because we got told we were doing a tag match, but obviously we didn't initially get told who would like have the match against. So we were like trying to think like, oh, it could be like, maybe this person and this person are like, are these two people getting put together for us for like a tag match? We completely didn't expect it was going to be like a Temple people. When we saw it, we're like, oh, okay, this will be really fun. I was like, it's going to be so fun that it's a completely different team that we're thinking of all together. So we just came up with like any and every new idea that we could.
That's awesome. That's what I'm kind of hoping, sort of Blackheart kind of introduce a tag titles at some point. I think that's one thing. Yeah. I love the weekly shows. I love what they're doing on YouTube. But for me as a wrestling fan, I'm just like, I just kind of want, you know, a few more tag matches every now and again, just and for them to mean something, for them to go somewhere.
Yeah.
Because with the weekly stuff on YouTube, they are very story-based. And I could see, you know, NRG chasing for the tag titles, and you guys turning up on YouTube, you know, every few weeks.
Yeah.
Matches, telling a few stories.
We'd love it, obviously. Because initially, like, both of us, I'm going to be honest, we weren't the biggest fan of tag wrestling, or we weren't into it as much as we are single. But when we got put together, obviously we started to look into it more, and we're like, we really went into it. It went from literally like from 0 to 100, where we're like obsessed, and we're like, cool, we can do this, like watching like different types of wrestling. We're like, oh, cool, we can like maybe change this spot from like picking it from like small things to like different matches. And we're like, oh, cool, it would be better if you did it like that, if I could do it like this, switching it up. So it was like, we found love from it when we actually became a tag team. And I feel like it's just stayed like that as well, that we both love like tag wrestling now, and we've like found like that it's sometimes like, I prefer it over like singles matches sometimes.
That's the thing, you know, but both of you aren't exclusively, you know, nobody thinks of you as just NRG or, you know, as either a part kind of thing, you know. Both of you guys are tearing up singly kind of thing. You know, I look forward to seeing either one of you doing single stuff on any given show.
Yeah.
But then also, I look forward to seeing you both as a tag team. You know, it's a 50-50 thing. It's kind of like, okay, I know singly you're going to turn up, you're going to, you know, deliver. And as a fan, I'm going to be entertained. As a tag team, as a fan, I know I'm going to be entertained. So it's a win-win for me.
Yeah.
And that's, but again, you know, from speaking to people, that's always one of the questions that kind of like, you know, comes up every now and again, like, you know, do you prefer tag team, do you prefer singles?
Yeah.
I always get told I'm an idiot for asking that question because they're both so very different, it's hard to compare.
Like I said, I prefer, I know I said I prefer tags, but I'm like, I do like some singles. I don't know, it's like
cheese and chalk, man. They're both awesome, chalk's not awesome. I don't know, it's like cheese and onion. I don't know, but both offer different things, and both allow you to be, you know, just to mix it up. Like I said, you know, you don't get that hot tag moment in a singles match. It's impossible. But when you're working
on tag, fire, moment, like when you finally get a tag, when the crowd just like exploding, fucking like just going crazy after it, it's like there's no feeling like that in like compared to like singles.
It's all about that hot tag, man. That's what a few people have sort of said. A few people who haven't called me an idiot for asking it, and I've actually picked one, I've turned around and said, oh, tag team wrestling, purely for that, you know, that hot tag moment, you know, that storytelling, whether you're the guy getting the hot tag or you're the guy diving halfway across the ring to make the tag. It's like, if you hit it, then you've got the audience, you know, in the palm of your hand. There's not many better pops in wrestling than that hot tag. So, but yeah, for me, Blackheart, you know, I'd like to see you guys, fingers crossed, you know, I'll try and sort of sweet talk James into doing some tag
titles. There's the Blackheart show this Sunday as well. Where it is, it's the Rumble. There you go, 20 man Rumble. So me and Hamza will both be in there. Well, let's see if one of us can win it.
But then that's going to diminish my attention.
No, we'll still be a team. It's fine. We don't argue. Well, not as much. We won't argue. It's fine.
Just don't eliminate each other. Don't be those guys. Just like Hartford Dan James. That's, you know, the returning Dan James, the armbar superstar. But yeah, dude, Blackheart. You know, Breakout, Pursuit. I say, fingers crossed, man. True Grit. You know, we mentioned UKW. Again, they're a promotion that's kind of very much sort of on the radar, but they've got the weekly episodic stuff as well. I know a lot of people that have kind of started off there, then kind of have moved on kind of thing. You still doing the UKW thing?
So I'm still like doing them as well as like doing other ones as well. So I'll eventually, so they just had a show on the Saturday, which I was against Joe Sedgwick, we were both like very happy with the match. I'd probably say it was one of my like favorite matches that I've had this year. We both like really enjoyed it. It was a really fun match. But yeah, I'm still like doing a bit of everywhere. Still here. Still going to like different places. It's just as much wrestling that I can do if I can get it. Just wrestling as much as I can, really.
Getting the reps in, dude. Again, from speaking to people, you know, I was saying 87% of it is, you know, networking, you know, there's a huge percentage of it as well that's just confidence, you know, and confidence that you get from doing stuff over and over and over and over again.
Yeah. Kind
of, because like muscle memory.
Yeah, even like confidence with like going in the crowd, because I'm going to be honest, like before, like I'm not the most like confident person or like the most outspoken person. Like when I first like was thinking of like debuting or when I was going to, I was like, I don't really want to do this anymore. I was like, do I really want to go out there? And I'm just like, I think I'll just stay back here actually. But yeah, but I feel like that's helped as well. Like continuously just going out in front of people is getting me like more calmer and like is getting more used to it as well.
I said it will do, man. The more, I suppose, you know, the obviously like you say, the more you go out, the more you talk to people, yeah, the more you work in front of people, and they're reacting to what you're doing, you know, that kind of boosts your confidence because it's kind of like, okay, yeah, they get it. They can see what I'm doing. They're reacting to what I'm doing, and they appreciate it. So maybe yeah, I'm really freaking good at what I'm doing.
So maybe I'm like, okay, cool. At least I know I'm like, I kind of know what I'm doing then. I'm like, still, yeah, kind of, I think.
I don't totally suck. You know, they're not booing me out of the building. So yeah, they take confidence and being like, that's the thing, you know.
Not like throwing stuff at me or anything. I was like, just like throwing drinks or like food. I'm like, oh, great, thank you guys.
Just walking out like that. Yeah. But again, dude, I know what you're saying with confidence thing. You know, it kind of sucks as well because, you know, 100 people could say, you know, amazing things. One yeah, person's gnarly about it, and it's that one gnarly thing that kind of gets stuck, and it's like, oh, yeah, you know, it kind of gets stuck in a loop. But you say, yeah, the more you do it, the more positive stuff you hear, you feel. It's just going to get better and better and better.
Yeah, yeah, 100%. Just about getting the reps and just getting more comfortable with like anything and everything in like wrestling.
I think that's why so many people, you know, kind of pick up like, you know, the summer camps kind of thing, or, yeah, you know, if you get a chance to do something like that, you know, where you're working like 2 or 3 times a day.
Yeah, yeah. It's
just repeat.
Literally like rep after rep. There was something similar. I think there was a, we did something not too long ago. It was the Huddersfield Comic Con. That happened. So it was me and Quinn there, as well as some guys from Contract Wrestling, which is based up in Newcastle, I want to say.
Yes, Gunnar Rigg was there. I saw it on Gunnar Rigg.
Yeah. So yeah, Gunnar Rigg was there because I saw him after a while, because I initially first met him when, because went to go train with Rampage. I've been there like once. I've intended to go down again more often, but I just haven't got the chance really. I need to make time for that as well. But yeah, I initially met him because we did like a training match. So that's where we got to know each other and we started talking. I was like, he's again another one that's really good in the ring. But yeah, we met again obviously at the Comic-Con in Huddersfield, and that's when again it was, not gonna lie, I was like shitting myself for it. I was like, oh, it's probably like gonna be in like a building, like we're gonna do this. We got there to set the ring up and I'm like, oh cool, where's the building? And like, it's here, and we're like in the middle of the street, and I'm like, okay. I'm like, that's cool. I was like, I didn't expect that. I'm like, that's fine. But yeah, it turned out to be really fun. After how scared I was for doing it, it was really fun with like people that aren't as like knowledgeable or wrestling or not that big into it. They were, even if they were still like coming around, they were still reacting, making noise, or like they were still like involved in it, which is like the best part. Because I was like, okay, cool. If you can get someone that's not as interested, then I'm like, cool. I know I've doing something right then, at least.
Yeah, what you're doing is getting their attention. And like I said, yeah, that must be like so much harder than even like say, you know, the holiday camp things, because those people have turned up to watch a show, whether they like wrestling or not, you know, part of the holiday.
Yeah.
They've still gone there to watch a show. That's something like that. Like say you've got just people walking past and you've got to be constantly on it just to for a split second to get their attention and then hold it.
Yeah, because it was the first time that I was like wrestled outside as well, and I'm like, I don't think I've ever wrestled outside. Like, I'm like, so it was really good with that. I was like, it wasn't well, it was raining at the start, but it got sunny, which was better. But yeah, we did like a couple of reps where we were doing like a couple of matches. I think on that day we almost did about four matches. So I was like, it was. I still like fucking loved it though. It was honestly so good.
Dude, and kudos to you as well, mate, because like I said, you know, the anxiety or just the doubt of like That is totally so far out of your comfort zone that it would be very understandable just to be like,
yeah, I was like, I'll just leave. I was like, Quinn, you can win this time for once. Quinn always wins. There you go. But I was like, I'll just leave. I was like, no.
But the more you do stuff like that, mate, it's going to build, like, say, your confidence. Yeah, and again, you know, not to sort of repeat myself, but that is key. You know, you do stuff like that, you throw yourself out of your comfort zone and do it.
Yeah. Mate,
you're just going to get stronger, more confident. And at some point, it's just going to be a case of, like, you know what? Nothing's going to phase me here. I'm going to go out and I'm just absolutely going to smash it.
100%. Again, I was like, just confidence. I feel like slowly that I started to get that now, I feel like a bit more comfortable in the thing as well. Yeah.
It'll come, dude. It won't come. It's already come. You must have got the, you know, to do what you've done already, kind of thing. But it'll just get better and better and stronger and stronger. And don't get too. You're gonna look like Nathan if you get too confident. You know, you don't want to be a Nathan Black kind of ego.
But stay humble, but confident. There you go.
Talking about, well, kind of going back to Pursuit again. I've obviously, you know, noticing like Will Cruiser's turning up a hell of a lot more now these days. There,
yeah.
You get to work with Will, kind of, he's a good big man to sort of bounce off of.
Yeah, yeah. I feel like Will Cruz is always there. Again, he's another one that was really good for feedback, especially because, like, what he's done as well. Like, he was recently, well, not recently, it was a while, yeah, recently when he was at NWA as well, which was, like, another thing, which I was, like, again, my mind was fucking blown. When I saw him on there, I was, like, that's amazing. But, yeah, again, he's another one that's really good for, like, feedback and, like, talking to as well, like, getting advice from us. As well, for like a different style, especially with like the big man style in terms of like what to do against someone that size, like if you were a bit smaller. So it's good to like get, again, different perspective as well.
That's it, because yeah, you're looking at it, so I'm like, yeah, I'm not expecting you to work, obviously work the big man style,
but yeah.
Really be like, look, if me and you were in the ring, you know, what's the best way to approach it, kind of thing, you know, is it just like dodge, dive, dip, you know, dodge again, or, you know, do we keep bouncing around, or... It just helps you to learn, to work a different, against different opponents, doesn't it?
Yeah, because it's him and, like, another big guy like Kemper. Obviously, Kemper, the monster he is, just destroying everyone in the ring. But yeah, he's another one. I was like, he'd be one that I'd love to have a match with him as well.
Yeah, because, again, you could just go in and you've got that, obviously, you'd have to be working face, you know, you've got that sort of underdog. You know, energy straight off kind of thing. The crowd are going to be rooting for you. Dude, you mentioned him earlier, you know, like a Rey Mysterio kind of thing, you know.
Flying around.
That's another, like, when you first got into training kind of thing, I always like to kind of pick people's brains, but, like, you know, when you first started then, you know, obviously you kind of walked in, you've been, you know, been told to come along, talked into it. You go there with kind of like a move set in mind of what you wanted to learn, what you wanted to get to, or did you just turn up and sort of see what felt naturally? Did you just go there being like, right, I'm going to be the next Rey Mysterio, I'm going to be bouncing around the rings, I'm jumping off the turnbuckles, or did you go there and be like, we'll see how it works?
Yeah, I was like, I don't really know what to do. I was like, I feel like I will try to be like, well, again, try is a key word, try to be like fucking Rey Mysterio, Eddie Guerrero, like Rob Van Dam. The one move that I really wanted to do was like, that I use mainly is like the split leg, just because of like Rob Van Dam. I was like, I fucking loved every time he did it. So I was like, I want to do this move. So I was like, this is one move that I'm going to try to do. And I was like, I'm going to keep this move. But yeah, after that, it was just like seeing what would like work and what I quite like the look of in terms of like getting into like different moves as well. I feel like it depends on the person and how they are in terms of like the body and like shape and size. Because some people like might be easier to do like, I'm trying to think off the top of my head. For example, I'm like kicks, for example. So like, someone that's a bit more flexible, like, I kick. Someone like might be able to kick the head off someone. Well, like, obviously, if you're not as flexible, if you can't reach. So it's like, it just depends on everyone, like how everyone is different, and like just trying different moves and see if it feels right for you, and how like you work it into it really as well.
That's it. Like I said, yeah, you can walk through the door and be like, right, you know, I want my move set. I want to work towards being able to have like, you know, like a Rey Mysterio move set, and then you do it a couple of times. You're like, you know what, that's not actually for me, you know, I'm just either not comfortable, you know, that freaking just hurts too much, you know, I'm not, you know, let's just turn it down a notch and we'll try and do more of a, you know, like an RVD, but it's a bit, there's a bit of area and a bit of ground, you know,
I think it always happens with like moves when you're like, oh, this will be such a cool move that I can do. You try it, like I've tried loads of moves that are like BBW, like in like when it's like the open ring session, we just try anything. I've tried a move, I'm like, this does not work. I'm like, it hurts, I don't like it. And it completely switches your mindset. I'm like, I don't want to do this anymore. I'm like, I will not do this move ever again.
I can't fault you, but then sometimes obviously you'll try something and it'll just be like, right, that was so smooth, that felt right.
Yeah.
Right, well we'll stick with that one and we'll work it and we'll make it look absolutely boss kind of thing.
Yeah. Again, it's just like literally just try and error. Just see what works with you. If it doesn't, it's fine. There'll be somewhere else.
That's what training is for. That's what the school's for. Like, so and people getting feedback off, like you could probably do something. Somebody would see it and be like, right, that didn't look right, but do this instead. Or just tweak it a little bit, maybe go off this way instead of that way.
Yeah.
It's just different enough and it feels right.
Yeah, that's the main thing. Obviously, if I'm doing something, I'll get someone's opinion. I'm like, does it look all right? Does it not look all right? I'm like, if I get people saying, like, oh, yeah, that's fine. I'm like, cool, I can keep this. If not, I'm like, I'll just leave it. It's fine.
Yeah, that's it. So, yeah, it always kind of interests me, because, like, you know, if people go in there, you know, just to like a clean slate or with expectations of what they think they're going to be able to do, and then versus reality, and it'd be like, oh, okay, maybe, you know, because we've all played freaking, you know, like the WWE video games kind of thing, and, you know, create a wrestler, you know, we've all
been like, oh my God, I can do like shooting star presses, I can do like this to the outside, like in reality, and you're like, oh, I'm scared to go to the top rope, I don't like this.
Right, no, as soon as the turnbuckle wobbles a little bit.
Yeah, oh, Mark, I'll just get down. I was like, I'm just going to sit on the floor instead.
But yeah, man, it was cool. So, I mean, you mentioned obviously, you know, RVD as well, kind of thing. It's again, he's for me, he's in my top five. I love RVD.
Yeah,
very few people kind of acknowledge him or ever reference him when I'm talking to him. So, as soon as you said RVD, I'm like, okay, hang on a minute, right?
Yeah,
I'll put a pin in that, I'll bring it up later. So, RVD fan, then I presume.
Yeah, I was like, I feel like he just has like a different like style of wrestling, because I feel like he has like, it's like a martial artsy plus like a high flyery type, which I feel like it's something that I would like to go more towards. Obviously, he has like the high flying stuff, and he has like, it's just every time I watched him wrestle, I'm always like, I always find something. I'm like, oh, this is like, it's something that I always notice from like old matches every time I watch it. I'm like, oh, he's done this. I'm like, oh, this would be cool if you do that. Don't know what's happened there. Don't know what's happened. And it's like, oh, it's always something that you notice with him. And it's like, it can either be something big where you're like, oh, that's cool if you can do it like this. Or if it's something smaller, like, I can take this and like maybe apply it to like how I do it instead. So it's like little things that I can change and like tweak around. But yeah, he's obviously one that I was like, I love watching. I was like, you just can't beat him. I feel like he's one of the best. I feel like very underrated.
Dude, I'm right there with you. And that's, yeah, I totally agree. Like I said, it's a dude to my top five. I'm of the age where, you know, I remember like ECW, like late 90s kind of thing, and then seeing him turn up in the Invasion, being one of the very few guys that actually got over during the Invasion kind of thing. So, you know, that ECW one night stand when it's him against Cena, dude, it's just so many cool moments.
Yeah, I feel like, again, like I said, I feel like he's really like underrated in that sense. But I feel like, I don't know, I feel like it's just everyone's opinion as well. I feel like he's just one of the wrestlers that I just got drawn towards. Him, Rey Mysterio, Eddie Guerrero, like the main three that I can remember watching and be like, they're like the really good ones.
Eddie is the best of the best, and I will not hear a word said otherwise. I'm sat here with an Austin hoodie on. I love Austin.
Eddie's the best of the best, Austin 316.
Eddie's just bar none the greatest wrestler ever, in my opinion. Yeah. If anybody wants to come at me, feel free, we'll talk about it. But yes, it's just perfect. So, but again, you know, to just to, I'll let you get gone soon, I'm keeping an eye on time. But so are you still able to watch wrestling as a fan, or do you kind of find yourself sitting there with a little internal notebook in your head being like,
I feel like watching it as a fan now, I feel like it's really hard, unless I'm like really invested in the matches. I'm like, oh my God, this is so cool. But like sometimes I watch it, I'm like, oh, this is cool, they did this and this, and I'm like, oh, this is where this happens. I'm like, ah, this is not the spot that they usually do. I'm just like, I'm ruining the match for myself. I'm like, why can't I just watch it? And I'm like, I feel like that's one thing now that I've started wrestling. I'm like, when I watch it, I'm like, I don't enjoy it as much, just because I know some things. I'm like, I'm like making mental notes, and I'm like, I need to stop doing this and just enjoy watching like my favorite wrestlers rather than taking notes of stuff.
You need to turn it off, yeah. But obviously, yeah, it's hard to do, dude. Because,
yeah.
You know, you're behind the curtain now. You know, you kind of know. It's like when you watch the magic tricks of the masked musician kind of thing. Magician. But... I always struggle to say that word. I've set myself up for that. yeah, you kind of know. But I suppose on the flip side, you know when you've watched a really good match because you switched off. So you'd be like, that was a good match. Because I didn't think about, you know,
I was just watching it and just like enjoying everything. And I wasn't like, oh, they did this, they did that, I can take this, I can take that. I'm just like, I was just invested in like everything from like bell to bell, entrance to entrance.
Dude, I mean, what are you watching at the minute? Do you find yourself, you know, obviously between training and doing shows, do you even have time to watch much wrestling anymore? Because that's always on the flip side as well. You know, people get into this because they love wrestling. And then the more that they do, they end up obviously watching less wrestling because they don't have time to do it.
To be fair, I'm starting to watch it more now and doing that sort of like watch studying, like tape watching. I feel like North's like a very good one because I feel like they push out like loads of like free matches. So every time I see it, I'm like, cool, I can watch this. So I've been watching like loads of North recently. Like I rewatched like Liam and Leon from like Thunderstruck last year. I watched like an old match with Amir Jordan and Chris Brooks. There's another one with oh my gosh, who
was
it? I've forgotten it.
Dude, there's so many on North. Yeah, North I've
just been
YouTube
watching loads and I can't remember which ones, but like they're the main recent ones that I watched, let's say. But yeah, North's like the main one that I will go to and I'll be like, cool to have like loads of different people that I can watch different styles, different match types. I'm like, I feel it's North is like one of the top ones up there, I'd say.
Leon Slater, Speedball, Mike Bailey.
Yeah, again, Speedball, he's another one. I love watching him. I was like, he's another one where I'd be like, I could watch his matches for like days.
It's the martial art thing. It is.
Yeah.
I don't want to make comparisons. I don't want to say like, but you know, if I can't watch an RVD match, I watch a Speedball Bailey match.
Yeah, because I'm just like similar styles, and I'm like, I quite like what they do. So I'm like, I'll just. It was not this wrestler. I was like, I can watch this one instead. I was like, there's loads of different options.
Yeah. That's the awesomeness of YouTube. That's hence what I get on my soapbox about it so often. You know, especially like promoters and promotions, you know, they're putting free matches on there and it's like, you know, you're getting fans in, you get people watching it. It's just, I love it when a promotion embraces YouTube because it's just kind of like, as a fan, you know, I get the benefits of it. It's awesome. So,
you'll get to watch matches like, which you've never seen. And I'm like, oh, I completely forgot this match existed. And I'm like, I want to watch this right now.
There's just so much stuff out there. And obviously, you can only go to so many shows, you know. You can only travel so far so often. You know, there's this promotions down south that I'll watch purely on YouTube because I can't ever get there. Like Sacrifice, you know, things like that. So, promoters, get your shit on YouTube so we can watch it if we can't make it to the show. So, dude, it has been an absolute pleasure. We've gone over the hour mark. Don't want to keep you for too long. Thank you so much for talking, but obviously like we'll start wrapping up. Not wrapping up just yet. We're halfway through the year. We've made reference to, you know, I'd love to see it, True Grit kind of thing. Is there anywhere, you know, I always kind of think wrestlers have got some sort of lists, you know, things they want to tick off. Even if it's just like a year by year one, I'm not saying, you know, a bucket list, but for the remaining of 2024, have you got any sort of boxes to tick or anywhere you'd like to be?
Again, I usually do it like year by year. I was mainly like trying to get out more in terms of like wrestling at different promotions, which I have started. But I want to wrestle, for example, like a title. That's one that I'd want to have on my list, as well as a True Grit. They're like the two main ones what I'd love to do.
I'll see if I can. I know the dude who does the Tidal socials, so I'll see if I can put a word in. I'll see if I can. We'll start doing like a pro NRG or pro Mo kind of a post.
Promo protest. Little protest. Get a sign. Promo protest. Promo. There you are.
It's a promo.
It's meant to be.
Dude. I'm on fire tonight with these puns, these word associations. So yeah, dude, I mean, fingers crossed, like I said, I don't see a reason why it's not going to happen. I sort of said, you know, we've mentioned Blackheart, we've mentioned Breakout, UKW. Planet Wrestle. Planet Wrestle is a massive tick box to tick for me.
I think that was one this year as well. So I'm happy I ticked that one because I initially got asked for that one like last year, but I couldn't make it because I had like something came up, so I couldn't make it. So I was gutted for that one. So that's why when I got asked this year, I was like, "Yep." I was like, "I don't care, cancelling everything. I'm going and I'm wrestling on Planet Wrestling."
Just by association, right? So I said, you know, the people that run that show, the people that run that show, you know, if they like you, dude, they will tell loads of people how awesome you are. And you know, the fact that you've been on two shows, but you're coming back for the third show, obviously you've made a great impression. You know, yeah, it's mo love, mo money. I'm quite proud of myself.
All the more puns. There you are. Just keep them coming. Keep them coming.
No, I'm going to go before my head explodes full of momos. Mo moments. Dude, it's been an absolute pleasure, mate. Thank you so much for taking time out to talk to me. I'll see you at future shows. But where can people find you and see what you're doing on the socials?
I am on Instagram and X, Twitter. Whatever you want to call it, momentum more_ MENTTUM. Find me Instagram there. You can find me X on there as well. Main two ways that you can interact. I've also got a Facebook as well. Again, search momentum TTS. Again, you'll find me there as well, where I post highlights, any reels that I've done, any updates of where I'm wrestling as well.
Sweet. Obviously, we'll tag you in loads of stuff as we upload this anyway. So if you're not following Mo already, please click that follow button. Check out all the stuff that's, he's posted already. Check out the highlight reels, shows he's been on, shows that are coming up. And if he's on a show near you, buy a ticket, go show some appreciation and just, show some love. So as always, I will say thank you for watching. Hit like, subscribe, share, comment, do all the generic stuff I always tell you to do. And we will see you again very soon. Speaking of the big man, Kemper, I'm talking to him on Wednesday. Keep your eyes peeled for that episode towards the end of the week. And thank you for watching. Mo, again, mate, thank you so much for coming on and talking to us.
Again, thank you for having me. Honestly, I've loved it. Nice little hour chat we had.
Exactly. Right, we'll see you again very soon. Goodbye.
Take care. Bye.